Hello everyone, this is Srikant, working as esteemed professor in electrical department. Now we are moving to one more topic, that is inspection method. We have the mesh analysis, nodal analysis, super mesh, super node. We have different analysis. Using those analysis, when you are applying the KVL and KCL rule, we will get the equations. Alright, we will get the equation. If suppose you are solving that equation using calcs, but if you want to solve the equation using inspection method also. So this is a one most important method. It will be helpful for in your different analysis. Okay, we will check it now. So using mesh analysis and nodal analysis, we have equations. Suppose this is my equations. Same, if you have three loops, you have the three equation. If you have three nodes, we have get like three equations. If you have the two means, we have get two equations. Okay, if you have the three loops, we have the three equations. If you have the three nodes, we have the three equations. Okay, same thing, I have three equations and I need to find out like suppose current. Current equations means, mesh analysis means, we will get like I1, I2 and I3. If you want to find out the mesh currents, we have the I1, I2, I3. If suppose we have like voltages, so that means super node or node analysis, we have like V1, V2 and V3. Okay, now I have three equations. So can you write the equations in matrix form? These three equations. Okay, you can write the three equations in matrix form. Those are A, B, C, D. So these are values. So A1, B1, C1, D1. So A1, B1, C1 and D1 equal to D1. And X, Y, Z is your I1 current values are voltage values. Current values are voltage values. Suppose I am considering here X, Y, Z. Okay. So 3. A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. You can write in matrix form. Simple. That is a simple. You can write the matrix form, those equations. Now, so using this matrix, you can find out the X, Y, Z values. For this, we have one method, that is Cramer's rules. So we know about this Cramer's rules. So if you want the X value, so that is del of delta 1 by delta value, del of delta. So del of delta 1 by del of delta, same thing Y value, del of delta 2 by del of delta, same thing Z value, del of delta 3 by del of delta. So what is it, delta and delta 1, delta 2, delta 3 values? It's very simple. So delta is nothing but that is your main matrix. So this is your delta matrix. So that is your delta matrix, and del 1 is nothing but, so where you want x1, you want to find out the x1 value, then x1 of values, which values we have, just remove that values and substitute your equaled values. Simple. This is a x of like a1, a2, a3 values. Just remove the a1, a2, a3 and write the d1, d2, d3. Suppose I want to go for the delta 2. Delta 2 means y values. Y values means remove the y values and replace with the equaled values. Same thing here, delta 3, remove the z values. That means c1, c2, c3 values and replace it equaled values, d1, d2, d3 values. So this is your delta, delta 1, delta 2 and delta 3 values. Then find out the del of delta as well as del of delta 1 as well as del of delta 2 as well as del of delta 3. And just find out the x, y, z. Here we have the x, y, z. In exam we have the mesh analysis. Using inspection method, find out the mesh currents. Then you need to use this method. There we have mesh current means I1, I2, I3, I need to find out. Here in X replace with the I1, I2, I3. So we'll solve one problem, we'll get the answer. Okay. Now this is my circuit. Same circuit I solved with the mesh analysis. This circuit now. So in this circuit, so using inspection method, find out the mesh analysis currents. Using inspection method, find out the mesh analysis current. Now using mesh analysis, I need to write the equations now. You can write directly also. So this is my loops, loop 1, loop 2 and voltage drops. We know that using mesh analysis. Now I will write the equation directly means, at loop 1 is observed clearly, at loop 1, how many resistors we have? So here also I1 is there. Same thing here also I1 is there. So I1. So 2 plus 3, how much? 5 I1. And at 2 ohms, I have only one current. At coming to 3, I have 2 current. So I write the value for I1 and write the second current. So which current? Second current? I2. So I1 and I2 both are same direction. So I need to write like plus, and I2 value is 3 into I2 equal to, what is the voltage source in this branch, in this loop? In this loop, my voltage source is 5. Okay. Now I can write the equation directly means, I require the number of resistors we have in this loop. That is I1 into 2 plus 3. So we have I1 current. So I1 is there. I1 at 2 ohms we have, as well as 3 ohms we have. That means 5 I1. Clear? At 3 ohms I have the I2 also. So both are same direction means I have the plus 3 I2 equal to your voltage source. Same thing coming to like loop 2 I1. If I write like I1 value means I1 as well as I2, both are same direction. So I need to write like 3 I1 plus. So plus 3 I1 again plus I2 values. So I2 we have 3 ohms as well as 4 ohms. So 7 I2 equal to, what is your voltage source? 10. So these are the two equations. You can write directly also. Otherwise you can go for the like step by step and get the same answer. Okay. In mesh analysis, we have the two loops. So in that mesh analysis, in this circuit, using mesh analysis, we have two equations. So two loops, two equations will get. So two equations. Then I need to go for the inspection method. So inspection method means, so I need to write this equation in matrix form. Okay. So I1, I2, same I1, I2 and 5, 3, 3, 7. So in matrix form, you can write like 5, 3, 3, 7. So 5, 3, 3, 7. Same. And I1, I2. So I1, I2. You have only two equations. So we will get like 2 into 2 matrix. So 2 into 2 matrix means 5, 3. You can write like a 5, 3, 5, 3 and 3, 7. 3, 7. You can write directly also. Okay. And there I1, I2 equal to 510. Equal to 510. Okay. Now I have a matrix form. Then I need to find out the Cramp's rule. So I need to use the Cramp's rule now. So from Cramp's rule, I1 is del of delta 1 by del of delta. Same thing, I2 means del of delta 2 by del of delta. Now I need to write the del value, delta 1 value, delta 2 values. So del value is same as your main matrix, and delta 1 is, and I need to remove the I1 values and replace with equal values. Okay, replace with equal values. That is 5, 10. 3, 7 is as it is. 3, 7 is as. Coming to delta 2, 5, 3 is as it is. I need to remove the 3, 7 and replace with 5, 10. Okay, that is I2 values and replace there. Now, and find out the I1 value means, what is your del of delta 1 as well as, and you find out the del of delta 1 and you find out the del values, del of delta. So del of delta 1 and del of delta values are, so del of delta is 5 into 7 minus 3 into 3. So 35 minus 9, we'll get the answer 26. Same thing here. 30, 5 minus 30, we'll get like 5. Okay, and here 50 minus 15, so 5 into 10, 50, 3 into 5, 15, we'll get like 35. Okay, substitute those values in your I1, I2 values. So I1 is delta 1 is 5 by 26, and I2 is 35 by 26. So 26 is common, del of delta 1 is 5 and del of delta 2 is 35. That's it. Substitute those values, you will get the same answer. So same thing using mesh analysis also, if you solve directly also, you will get the same answer, I1 and I2. So this is about the inspection method. When you have the mesh analysis, node analysis, as well as a super mesh, super node, then we have the equation. If you solve those equations using this method also. Okay. Thank you for watching.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.